You're back with us at the R3 RoadShow from 91 Spring Roads in Andheri East in Mumbai. We're here today as our last stop on this roadshow, which has traveled across six cities, Mumbai being the last one. The R3 RoadShow really looked at helping women reassess themselves to reskill so that they can restart. We're from Jobs for Her. If you've been following us, then you know what we're all about. But if not, then Jobs for Her is an online connecting portal that looks at bringing women who left their careers midway for multiple reasons back to work. And to do that, we're not just providing jobs online, but we're helping you go that extra mile by helping you reskill, by getting mentored, by through women who are willing to step up to the plate. If you want it, just look us up at www.jobsforher.com, where you'll find mentors, reskilling, plenty of inspirational stories and more. We're continuously at it. Sitting here with me right now is Dr. Komal, who is HR Head India Business for TCS, and Armin Billimoria, who is the Senior Director, Legal and Company Secretary at Capgemini. Like we promised you an impressive line of mentors, we have two of them sitting with me before they proceed to the mentoring session, which starts shortly. Moving to Dr. Komal, who has been involved with Jobs for Her for a bit now, who was telling me about a webinar that she ran a couple of days ago. Komal, would you like to tell our women a little bit about your association with us and what was your experience at the webinar, what it was about?
Sure. As a woman who has taken a couple of career breaks herself, nothing feels closer home than being with women who are like-minded, who are also very keen to continue with where they left off and are just seeking that little hand-holding and help to get started. So it's been wonderful to be a part of this entire roadshow and the webinar that we had as initial activity as part of this roadshow. And what I find is that there are so many experienced women out there. Some were lacking that confidence to get started. I think it's a matter of knowing what to take as those initial few steps to get back to right where they were, and kind of take their right place.
Armin, you were telling me about your interactions with some second career women, and very interestingly, what you've noticed that what they are struggling with. Also, some insights as to what they need to do while they're on their career break. Would you like to share that with our viewers?
Yeah, sure. My observation, little bit on the career comeback that we do in our company is that we encourage career comebacks, and not only that, even we encourage our own Capgemini employees who have taken a career back to come back. Having said that, we also have some short courses that we organize in the company for, especially for these career comeback ladies. And we seniors, we have formed a group, and we consciously see to it that we have in our organization someone who is coming back. Having said that, our observation is that women themselves should be prepared mentally when they are having a career comeback. Some people come back after a short break of 7 or 8 months, but some do take longer breaks like 4 to 5 years. Now in 4 to 5 years, the technology which they were accustomed to has gone under a big change. Now you have to upscale yourself. Now when you are upscaling yourself, what happens is that maybe when you come back, you may be getting a position which may not be up to your liking, because your peers may have become seniors, and there are occasions wherein you have to even report into them. So these things need to be kept in mind, that these things should not come into your way. These are little egoistic things which will make you unhappy. But if mentally you have prepared for yourself that yes, when I come back, these things will happen to me, you will be very, very happy joining back. And once you have upscaled yourself, you will get your rightful position. That's for sure. Now, when you are on career breaks because of maternity or taking care of your own parents, I have come across certain women who have to take career breaks not for having a kids or something, but only to take care of their old ailing parents. And this is a really a very wonderful thought. And one should not feel after some time that why I took this break and you know I should have kept a maid or something like that. It's a very good thought and you should not feel guilty. But when we are on career breaks, one mistake that many women make is that they don't upskill themselves. Be it any field, be it legal, be it technical, be it any field, things are changing at a very rapid pace currently. It's not as it was when I started my career. When things are changing so quickly in our lives, you have to be up to date with some information. If you want to be something, say a finance, if finance is your thing, what are the changes in the act? What are the changes in the income tax laws? If this little things you have updated yourself, your new manager will also start taking interest. Because he knows that you already know the book part of it and he doesn't have to teach you everything. What he will explain to you or something as to how this can be put in practice. And that is really one effort that all women who are on breaks should take.
Thank you, Armin. Yes, Komal, because I think the importance of continually skilling oneself cannot be overemphasized. Then I find a lot of women needing help, and I've spoken to a number of them, is their own getting themselves sorted emotionally. So when one comes back to work, one obviously needs to put one's own house in order, so to say. You need to plan for your absence, you need to plan for people managing without you at home, so that when you're getting back to work, it should not be a difficult experience even for your employer that you're continually taking breaks to get back to sort things back home. So while these things look small, they're actually very important things to consider when getting back to work. I find a lot of women feeling very guilty about having taken that break. And I think the very important message is that you should not feel guilty at all, because you know your circumstances and the reasons why you took that break and the reasons why you are willing to come back now and why you can come back. So to be able to take that forward confidently will also give your potential employer the confidence to take you back. So it's now, yes, you're looking for your next dream job. You probably had one which you had to give up. You're trying to get back there. There are times when you may not get that dream job at one go, in your very first interview or your very first opening that came your way, which is fine. My advice to women wanting to come back is take the first best thing that comes your way, because the longer you wait for your dream job, that much more time you are losing in actually getting back to work. So take those smaller steps, take calculated steps. It doesn't mean you have to jump at the very first offer you get. It should be something that appeals to you, that is also in line with your skills, your qualifications, and even giving you the remuneration that you deserve. And that takes me to the next point, which is women are also a little hesitant to negotiate when they do get that first offer, because they feel, okay, this is something I'm getting today. I don't know whether I'll get the next one. And is it even right? There were women who have asked me, is it even right to negotiate? My answer to that is, why not? You should not feel shortchanged. You are coming back. You are going to give those number of hours to the organization. And you need to demonstrate the confidence you have in yourself by negotiating your right remuneration. So that's important too. Fantastic. That was some really valuable advice. You took a career break for reasons that were known to you, and that was the need of the hour. So don't feel guilty about it, is what they're saying. But while you're on your break, make sure that you find ways to upskill, stay updated, and network, is what they're saying too. Armin, you were telling me about a second career woman who came back to Capgemini
yes.
after an 8-year break.
Yeah.
And you said she rose to a really accomplished position.
Correct.
So can you tell me from her experience or from what you saw, what it takes to do that after that longer break?
Yeah. I had a colleague with whom I used to work very closely, and not mentioning names, she took a career break of almost 8 years and then she joined Capgemini. But before she joined Capgemini, what did she do to get into Capgemini first of all? So when she had taken the career break, she was an ordinary graduate. But in these 8 years, she upskilled herself and she learned the technology. And that were the years when computers and all were just getting into India. So she learned the techniques. She put in hours of work. She got herself educated. Post which she took a job in a small techie company which was just next to her house, so that she could cater to the house needs and her job. So I remember her telling me that whenever there was something to be done, late night jobs, all those jobs were given to her. And in those days, there were those big printers wherein you fire a job and then it goes on those long printers. So she would be given those type of jobs initially. So the job would be fired. She would go home, have a look at her kids and all that, and come back to see whether the paper is jammed or not. And you know, so, and if you go to see, she rose up to the rank of a VP, and today she is no more with Capgemini, but she is working in another company where she is at the level of a CEO, a small time company, but she is the CEO. So that is how you can rise. And what lesson do we learn from her is that this 8 years, she just didn't let them go waste. She had two kids in between those 8 years, etc. But she kept on learning. She upskilled herself and she got herself to that level that anybody could take her in. And that's what is more credited.
Absolutely. Which is why we have events like the R3 Roadshow, which are being organized to help you realize what it is that you need to do to come back, to help you upskill in ways that you need to. Komal, you were just telling me that you were at a previous roadshow similar to this. So why do you think events like these are necessary today?
It is the sheer number of women who are so highly and so well educated today that it is very difficult to actually, you know, after one's immediate needs are addressed, be it the break for family reasons or for taking care of parents, when one does have the luxury of getting back to work, more and more women are choosing to take that up. So the sheer number of women in the workforce today is only rising, which is a fantastic thing from a diversity perspective, because organizations today need that diversity. Organizations are investing in building that diversity, which is why it is important that you know, there are opportunities for them to get together. It is a kind of a community building of sorts, which is what also helps them. Because when you're not working, you're really an island unto yourself. You need to build those networks. Those networks help you to gain, may not just be a job, but you know, how to, it's a support system.
Absolutely.
And I think it's wonderful. It is the need of the hour.
If a support system is what you need, then you should look up the Ambassador Community from Jobs for Her. The Ambassador Community is a network of women who have taken career breaks, are on their career breaks for multiple reasons, but have come together to support each other on their way back to a restart. If you want to know more about the Ambassador Community, email Sapna, S-A-P-N-A, at jobsforher.com. And she will take you forward on this. Calling it a wrap, we want to do a quick shout out to our sponsors and our partners who have been extremely supportive. Nestle, our sponsor, 91 Springboard, where we are at, our venue partner, My City for Kids and Women Now, who have been our outreach partners. A very big thank you to you for making the R3 Roadshow possible. Stay tuned because we have a lot more lined up for you.